expresses that we were about to do the written out of history as roadkill cultures of manifest destiny. And at that time, when a white man killed an Indian, he was given manslaughter. When the Indian killed a white man, he was given first-degree murder. A form of frontier justice was going on there. It became a sovereignty issue because of the treaties. Became a sovereignty issue because of the land. But most important, it became a sovereignty issue because of our spiritual ways. Declaration of defense. And that's what we're about, the American Indian Movement, in defense of our land, our spiritual ways, our culture. It's about defense of your survival for the children to come. In fact, the first Thanksgiving was commemorated after a massacre. The first governor of Massachusetts, with mercenaries surrounded Pequot Indians doing their green corn ceremony in their longhouse, surrounded them with mercenaries and set the place on fire. And when they ran out, shot them as they came out. And as a result, over 300 Indian people died inside the longhouse. A year later, the first Massachusetts governor commemorated, having gotten rid of the Indians, commemorated the first Thanksgiving in that memory.
Yeah.
obvious as the initiator of all the oppression that starts with us first and it goes out to the world. And one of the ways they do it is they get everybody to hate the victim. They got everybody to hate the Indian. I think Indian people, we still have a message to America. And yet America doesn't really care too much to hear the Indian point of view of things. Because America thinks progress is the answer. Well, it's really not. Because some things that the Creator put in a perfect place, all connected beautifully, it didn't need to change or improvement.